Hey everyone, it's Hunter and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we're getting festive. If you can't tell by my sweater, it's like way too big for me, but it's like the most beautiful Christmas sweater I've ever seen, so I had to wear it for this video. Anyway, so today's video, we are doing a Christmas gift guide slash gift ideas slash wish list kind of thing, whatever you want to call it. But I already filmed this video once and I didn't like it. I rambled for way too long. I didn't really have a plan going into it, so I decided to redo it, and I'm redoing it in my new Christmas background setup, so I hope you guys like it. And if you like this, then I filmed a video on how I created this space. So if you guys, I haven't uploaded it yet. I just filmed it before I filmed this video. So if you guys want to see how I created all this stuff, then you should subscribe to my channel so you guys can see it. And with that being said, follow me on Instagram for more Christmas festivities, and let's just get into it. I have a plan going into it this time. So the first group of people that I think that we're gonna start with is the men in your life. Men in your life are so hard to shop for, at least in my opinion. I think that they're really hard to shop for. My fiance is hard to shop for because I feel like if he wants something, he just goes and buys it. Same with my dad. And my brother is, I don't know, he always wants really expensive things, which is great. Like, that's fine. It means he wants quality stuff, but at the same time, I cannot afford his expensive taste. So that's why I am going to be giving you some ideas. There's only like three ideas, but we're gonna share anyway. So the first thing that I am going to recommend is a fragrance or a, so it's like kind of combined into two. It's like a fragrance, so like cologne or like a man's body wash, aftershave, or like something like that that they can use to make them smell good. I know that my fiance, whenever he bought deodorant, I was with him and he made me pick out which one I liked the best, the way that it smelled the best, and he bought that one. So if it's like a boyfriend or a fiance or something like that, then men like to smell good. At least I think they do. I know Mason likes to smell good. So you could get them something that will make them smell good, whether that is like a nice body wash. I know Bath and Body Works typically has really nice body wash for men. And I bought that for Mason last year and I loved the way it smelled. So 10 out of 10 would recommend that stuff. But then also just like cologne. A lot of stores do gift with purchases around this time of year for fragrances. I know that Ulta does like a bathrobe. So honestly, you could go get something. I think it's like if you spend $50 in fragrance, you get a bathrobe. And they are quality bathrobes. Like, I have one and it's really nice bathrobe. So you could get that and save that for a gift for someone else, or you could use it for yourself. It doesn't matter. Or you could get the men's bathrobe and use it for, give it to them. I don't know. Maybe they like wearing a bathrobe. Maybe they need a bathrobe, a new one or whatever. But you could get them something that will make them smell good. Because I think that when you smell good, when you know you smell good too, when you do that, you're a little bit more confident. So I think that that would be a really great gift idea. They can be a bit pricey, but I do know that like at Ulta, there are gift sets. So if you don't know what they like specifically, you could pick out a gift set that has several different fragrances in it and you could give that to them and they can kind of like choose which one they like the best. It's a good like toss up of fragrances. So just throwing that out there. Next is a razor subscription service. I know that I got my dad this for Christmas last year and he absolutely loved it. His handle broke or something. Also, we did it from the Dollar Shave Club. It's like $5 for the starter kit, or you can just get the razor for $1, and then you can choose whether you want a $1 razor, a $6 razor, or a $9 razor. And I got him the $9 razor, but he ended up wanting a different kind, so I got him the $6 razor. And I just paid for that for a couple of months. I did it every other month because he told me he didn't want it every single month because he just had so many blades, he didn't know what to do with them. So I did it every other month, and so it lasted 6 months, and I paid maybe $40 for the whole thing, and I thought that was a really good gift because I knew it was something that he would love, it was something that he would use, and like I said, he ended up really liking it, and if something is wrong with it, then they will replace your handle or anything like that. So it's good quality, but it's also way beyond worth the money. So, because razors can be really, really pricey, and to have them delivered to you all the time is really nice. That's all I have specifically for men. Like, just for men that I think that men would like. But for women, you could replenish someone's makeup. So if they have a foundation or concealer or lip balm or something like that that they really love, but they run out of a lot, you could replenish it. Whether they need it now or not, you could get it for them so that they have it when they need it. Or you could just buy them makeup that they like, or they don't have, or something that they've really had their eye on but they don't want to spend the money on. There are all kinds of new palettes that come out at Christmas time, and you know they're not going to have it because it's new. But if you don't know what they don't have, or you don't know what their shade is, or you don't know what kind of foundation they wear, you could always get them a gift card and write them a note and tell them that you bought them this gift card so that they could buy whatever it is that they wear. You could buy someone home decor if there's something they've had their eye on. You could always buy picture frames, mirrors, throw pillows, like neutral ones. I'm always down for some Christmas lights. I have them up all times of the year. And then I have like fairy lights right there, always down for that. Any kind of home decor is always a really good idea because people are always wanting to update what their home looks like. Nobody's ever really completely 100% happy with what their house looks like. At least that's what I've found. Like, most of the time you can have everything right and it still not be perfect to the person who is decorating the space. They always feel like they can do something to improve it. So I think that getting them any kind of home decor is always a good idea. And if you don't know, like I said, with the makeup, if you don't know exactly what they need or what they don't have, then you can always get them a gift card to Bed Bath & Beyond, to Target, to IKEA maybe, something like that, so that they can go in and pick out what they want. Or if there's something that they've been wanting for a really long time but you just don't know what it is, then you could get them something like that. Or if what they want is super, super pricey, then you could get them a gift card to contribute to them buying that. And you could just write them a note, like I said, with the makeup and just tell them exactly what you want them to use it for or what your intentions were with it. That doesn't mean they have to spend it on that, but that's always a good idea. Let's see, next is a stationery kit. I don't know about guys, but I know that mostly every girl loves stationery. So like journals, I'm a huge journal person. I have so many of them. My journal collection video on this channel has a lot of views and I was really shocked by how many views it got or how many views it continues to get. And the whole video is out of focus. Like, Hunter, what are you doing? But you could buy someone like a journal, new pens, things that like complement each other. So like I said, a new journal, some nice pens, not the cheap ones, but like the really good ones, like Sharpie pens are incredible. I love those. I use them all the time. You could get them a journal that comes with a pen. So like this one, let me grab the pen. This one came with a pen. You could buy them something like that. You could buy them stamps or like cards that they could send to people, because I know I really love that. You could put all that together in like a little gift set, and I think that that would be something that is just really thoughtful to put together, especially if you know that they like journals or they like writing stuff down. Sticky notes are always good, notepads, to-do lists, pencil like pouches, even pencils, you could buy them pencils, something like that. I think that that would be a really cute idea. Next, along with kind of like a kit thing, is if you know that they like baths or they're stressed out a lot, then you could buy them something like a bath or a relaxation kit. And when I say bath or relaxation, you could buy them bath bombs, a bubble bath, face masks, let's see what else, like a new loofah. If they use a loofah in the shower, you could buy them a new one, because everybody could always use a new one if they have one. It doesn't matter how long ago they just got a new one, they could always use another one. A body scrubber, a body scrub, like the product scrub, some lotions. Would be careful about lotions. If they like bath products, they probably have a lot of lotion. I know that I have a lot of lotion. I have two sitting on my bedside table as is. And if there's someone who's stressed out a lot, then they might get headaches. So you could get them like a cold compress for their face, or a heating pad. I know that a heating pad is really, really, really nice, like quality heating pad. I do not know where I would be today without my heating pad, to be completely honest, because that's always nice. Bath salts, anything like that. You could just go get a couple of those things and go to a thrift store, or even the Target dollar section has cute little things that you can put stuff in, and just put that together as a gift and give that to them. It's so much better and more thought out than a pre-made gift basket. And last but not least, specifically for women, or the ladies in your life, is jewelry. This does not mean that you have to buy your girlfriend a diamond ring. This does not mean that you have to buy the most expensive piece of jewelry there is. What I'm really talking about is like my necklace. It has my name on it. and I have this one that has an F because it's like really little, you can't even see it. But I layer my necklaces and I love layered necklaces. So honestly, this one was $28. You could go to madebymary.com is my favorite place and the place that I'm recommending you get stuff from. But they have rings that are stackable. I stack my rings. You can figure out what their favorite finish of jewelry is. They have gold stuff, they have rose gold stuff, and they have silver stuff. And you can personalize stuff. You can get them a gift card so that they can get their own jewelry if you don't know what they already have. I know that I would love to receive those things. So simple. If you want to buy one for your girlfriend or your wife or whoever, then there's one that says my girl or like your daughter. That's so cute. Like, I think that one's so cute. They have some that have like blooms on them. There's one that says inhale, exhale. There's one with a semicolon on it. There's so many different ones, and it could be something that means a lot to someone. Next is for like your techie person. I have... okay, yeah, just technology. It doesn't have to be a techie person, but technology related things I wanted to share. There's always a camera as an option. So I have my vlog camera. You could get someone an expensive camera if you're trying to spend a lot of money, but you could also get them something that's really simple. I would recommend Polaroid cameras. Those are really cool. Physical photos are always really fun. I have a wall of Polaroids here. So like, I got a Polaroid last year. I got a film camera the year before that. Like, I'm always here for a good camera. They already have a Polaroid camera. Figure out which one they have and get them some film, because no one will ever say no to film. They're really expensive and they go really, really fast. So that would always be something that's really thoughtful, because it means you pay attention to the things that they have and the things that they like. You could always get someone a new phone case. If you can't tell, mine's broken. Like, people always need a new phone case, and if they don't need it right away, then they're gonna need it eventually. Same thing with screen protectors. Mine is cracked as heck, so like, everyone gets tired of hearing, oh, is your phone cracked, when actually it's a screen protector. So you could always get someone like a phone case slash screen protector duo. Next is a wireless charging pad. I have one in my living room that Mason actually bought, but then my car, actually I have a mount in my car that charges my phone, but it's also magnetic, which is really, really cool, I think. And that kind of leads into a magnetic car mount. You can get them just a magnetic car mount, because I know that I play music a lot in my car because I'm in my car a lot. I also use my GPS a lot, so I just set it up right there, and then I'm able to look at it without being on my phone, like without holding my phone. I don't have to put it in my lap or anything like that, because I'm not constantly looking down to see like where I need to turn or something like that. And if I want to change a song, all I have to do is press the next button, and I don't have to like get out my phone and try to change the song if I don't like it or something like that. Next is a disposable camera. Those are always really fun. You could get them a couple of those, actually, because disposable cameras are like really fun to develop, and if they have a film camera, you could just get them film. Next is a watch band. If you know someone who has an Apple Watch or a Fitbit or a Samsung smartwatch, I don't even know what the other kinds are, but you could get them a watch band, whether it's a just another color. This one's blue, I have a white one, I have a pink one, so just like mix it up. Or you could get them one that is a cool pattern, you could get them a leather one, you could get them like a really hardcore one that like really protects the watch. For teens specifically, I thought about new bedding, new sheets. You could get them a gallon of paint, or tell them to pick out a color of paint and you could like go get it with them or something like that, so that they can kind of just like update, refresh their room. A backpack. My favorite is my Feel Robin Conkin backpack. It's on my wall over there, or else I'd show it to you. But they are kind of pricey. They're like $80. Mine was $115, but like, if you know someone who could use a new backpack, I use mine now just for like random stuff. I carry it with me almost everywhere, all the time. So if you know someone who is still in school or something like that, a backpack is always a good idea, especially a cute one, because then they'll want to use it more than just for school. It's a makeup mirror. Now, this is actually good for pretty much anybody that wears makeup, but a mirror that lights up, so like, it's like a personalized mirror that has lights around it. I got mine from Amazon for Christmas last year, so I got it while I was still in school. But it was just really nice to have, especially in my dorm, because then I was able to put my makeup on and just turn that light on, and I didn't have to turn any other lights on to put makeup on if my roommate was still sleeping. And I have one more category, which is just general things that you can buy people. A coffee maker, whether it is just a single pot kind of thing, whether it's a Keurig personalized coffee maker, I don't know what it is, an espresso, anything like that, any kind of coffee maker, tea maker, teacup, anything like that that has to do with like hot drinks, I'm always here for it. I am here for a good coffee maker, a French press, anything like that. You could go for those kinds of things. You could get some on candles. You can never go wrong with candles. So that's all I have for this video. If you guys enjoyed it, then give it a thumbs up and subscribe down below. You can also follow me on Instagram to find out more about my life if you just want to keep up with me. If you don't, that's cool too. It's fine. Anyway, I hope you guys have a great holiday season, that you have a good Christmas season. I hope that you decorate. I hope that the people that you buy gifts for will love them. And I hope that just Christmas is a good time. I hope you guys have a good time. Anyway, that's all. So I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!